The following is a fiber panel technical tape, which will demonstrate the techniques and methods used during the construction of a 1,256 square foot sample house in Phoenix, Arizona, using fiber panel modular wall panels. The videotape will take you through the construction of the house from the pouring of the foundation to installation of carpeting and vinyl floor covering. As in all home building, a good foundation is the key to solid construction. The fiber panel modular wall system follows these same time-tested principles. The footing, or the foundation, is similar to typical construction, including variations for basements or crawl spaces. Once the forms for the foundation are in place, a 2x4 wood stud or metal channel is installed along the outside perimeter of the foundation at finished floor elevation. As the foundation is poured, it is extremely important to move the concrete under the 2x4 channel to ensure proper leveling. When the concrete is nearly dry, the 2x4 is removed, leaving a 2x4 channel, which provides a lowered seat for placement of the fiber panels. After the slab is floated, a 1-inch hole is drilled in the wood or metal stud, and the J-bolt and 3/8-inch coupling nut is inserted in the concrete. The threaded coupling remains above the foundation level. Holes are drilled 2 3/4 inch from each starting corner and continued 4 foot on center. The coupling depth must allow a minimum of 4 to 5 turns of the threaded coupling nut. The holes must be accurately drilled in order to ensure proper alignment of the holes in the fiber panels. This step is very important. This pre-planned distribution of the panels allows installers to work efficiently during fiber panel installation. The foundation should be swept clean of dust and debris. Lay out the distance between the panels according to the blueprints. The interior and exterior walls, doors, and closet openings should be marked with a chalk line on the foundation to ensure proper measurement and placement of the panels. Remember, when laying out the panels for interior and exterior walls, it may be necessary to field cut a panel to fit corners or opening measurements smaller than the panel's 2-foot width. The seal between the panel and the channel is a critical part of the installation. It must continually be kept dry and swept clean of debris and dust. Otherwise, the adhesive will not adhere. Each tongue and groove edge should also be wiped or brushed clean. Pre-planning is important to help the panel installation crew, usually 3 or 4 workers. The basic items needed for the installation include construction adhesive, pry bars, and wood for bracing and shimming. All panel saw cuts for lintels above the windows, doors, and headers should be cut prior to erecting the wall panels. This will save time, and the installation will flow smoothly. Depending on local codes, grouted rebar may be necessary for extended door length or window lintels. Fiber panel installation should begin at an exterior corner which meets an interior wall to lend continuity and strength to the panels as they are installed. A bead of adhesive is applied to the channel in a continuous S shape. The panel is carefully tilted up into the channel, smooth side facing in. After the panel is in place, a threaded rebar, approximately 8'6" in length, is pushed through the corresponding hole in the panel and threaded into the foundation coupling, fastened to the rebar. First, tighten the rebar, then the coupling nut, by turning with a wrench 4 to 5 times. When the rebar is tightened through a double top plate on the exterior wall panels, kick out and longitudinal support results. The fiber panel modular wall has system and panel certification from HUD federal requirements, along with 120 plus mile per hour wind load and 0 flame spread. This particular house was also built to seismic zone 4 specifications for residential California codes. J-bars are placed in the foundation on either side of all doors and windows on exterior walls. The rebar is placed at 4-foot centers or at each vertical side of all windows or door openings, whichever comes first. After the first panel is installed, a bead of adhesive should be placed on the channel or tongue ready to accept the next panel. Again, adhesives should be placed in the clean channel and the next panel set. Note that the panels should be plumb at nub and not lean toward or away from the foundation. Other panels are then placed in the 2x4 channel and threaded rebar is pushed through the hole in the panel and fastened to the coupling in the foundation. The upper two wood plates are attached to the rebar through the top of the panel with a washer and nut. This is done on all exterior walls. The saw used for cutting panels was a basic 14-inch gas-powered concrete saw with a carbide tip blade. Only two blades were used for all panel cuts of the total 141 fiber panels. The saw cuts are clean, straight, and accomplished almost as quickly as saw cuts in wood. There is some dust created when using the saw. Safety glasses and a dust mask should be worn by the cutting crew workers. During installation, the panels are supported by a brace and cleat nailed to the top. Panel bracing should be monitored to ensure safety procedures during installation. Wire can be temporarily used to cross-tie the panels together until the top plates are installed and interior walls are in place. The interior walls should be installed as you progress. They add strength and continuity within the wall structure. Chalk lines should be made to indicate where the panels will be placed. An S bead of adhesive is put between the chalk marks and also on both sides of the nub of the corresponding panel. Rebar is not used in the interior walls. Instead, an L-shaped bracket called a fiber leg is inserted into the middle cell of all interior panels. The fiber leg is made of 10-gauge galvanized steel, which is riveted to the floor, and the panel is force-fitted over it. The fiber leg helps prevent the walls from kick-out. The fiber leg should be installed so the exposed riveted plate is eventually under carpeting. When the fiber leg appears in areas such as closets, bathrooms, kitchen, and room dividers, it becomes necessary to rivet the fiber leg under cabinets where possible. Lintels are easily installed into a cutout seat of a vertical panel. Number 4 rebar is installed through the 3/4-inch pre-drilled holes on each side of each door and window opening for wind load and uplift support. Codes will vary, and rebar positioning can be adjusted accordingly. Grout may be added to the cells where glue beams are set and where rebar is located. A nut and washer are then used to secure the rebar in place. It should be noted that all 141 panels of this sample house were installed in 2.5 days, using a crew of 4. Our crew consisted of 3 concrete workers and their foreman. The fiber panel system combines quality construction with minimal labor experience, a plus for affordable housing worldwide. The double exterior top plates are installed in a conventional manner, overlapping joints and tying in all exterior and interior walls. The double plate is used on the exterior walls only to allow for panel placement into the lowered foundation channel. All interior walls have a single plate cut and placed in a manner to ensure interior wall tie-in. The top wood plates are laid out, drilled, and nailed using standard nails directly into the fiber panels. The nails will hold just as if they were driven into wood studs. Once the plates are secured to the panels, they are ready to accept the trusses. Trusses can be laid across a flat surface from the front to the back of the house. The trusses used in our sample house were pre-manufactured and delivered to the job site ready for installation. This is our recommended procedure to help cut expensive labor costs. Remember, if the foundation slab is level and the walls were erected plumb, the trusses fit exact and tight. Once the trusses are installed, the remainder of the roof is applied using standard plywood sheathing, felt, and shingle construction. Fiber panels may be used for roofs in smaller homes with slight pitched roofs. The trusses in the bedrooms of the sample house form a typical 8-foot ceiling, while the trusses in the living room, dining room, and kitchen area form a vaulted ceiling, which is 2 feet higher at the ridge, giving the house an open and airy feeling. The roof trusses form a 2-foot overhang on all elevations, with an extra extension over the front door and walkway. An optional steel roof truss system, including the trusses, steel top plates, stringers, and metal roof pan, would reduce the cost of the conventional wood roof system by 10 to 20%. The chase wall between the bathrooms would have double fiber panels, and the ceiling would be USG Fire Code C 5/8-inch fire-rated gypsum board. This system, along with the fiber panels, would have a 2-hour fire rating, making the house virtually fireproof. The installation of electrical wiring and plumbing is just as easy as a conventional wood frame house. The electrician used a 4-inch router to cut out the switch boxes and outlets, placing them directly into the panels and securing with screws and nails. Rough wiring is run in a vertical direction through the holes in the panels and should be installed just after the trusses are erected. Using the fiber panels, it is estimated that a labor saving of 15 to 20% is realized over wiring a wood frame house and about 25% less time and labor for wiring a block house of similar size. One electrician roughed out this sample house in one day. Plumbing lines were hidden behind the kitchen cabinets and run through the master bedroom. Although this house did not require it, water lines can also be brought down from the ceiling through the vertical holes in the panels. Standard windows can be used in the fiber panel house. The window installation process, using a single or double pane window, is very simple. A bead of adhesive is put on the flange of the window and also on the window opening. The window is then screwed directly into the panel. A drip cap running the length of the window or door lintel may be added. The insulation used in the ceiling of this house was R30. The exterior of the house was covered with 1-inch polystyrene foam board for added insulation. Notice the foam is nailed directly to the panels and then wire stapled using conventional construction methods. The exterior walls were stuccoed using Western 1-coat with fiberglass. It is difficult to tell which kinds of materials are used to construct the exterior walls. The fiber panels achieve a conventional look with an innovative product, quality with economy. As an alternative to stucco, you could very easily fasten a beveled wood siding or a synthetic type of wood product or even brick veneer directly over the foam. The fiber panel is versatile, easy to install, and economical to use. The interior fiber panels are first prepared by placing 15-pound felt over the top of the double plate to prepare the walls for plaster base coat. Wire mesh or gypsum board is placed on the stud knee walls, which form the 2-foot vaulted wall extension. This is the only area where wire mesh or gypsum board is used on the interior wall partitions. Next, the seams are covered with a perforated plastic tape to minimize potential cracking after the plaster and finish coat are applied. The tape is adhering and does not need to be nailed or stapled. For a strong straight edge around each door, window, or corner, a steel corner bead, similar to that used in drywall finishing, is nailed or glued directly to the panel throughout the house. This is an option. Once the corner bead is installed, plaster is then troweled over the corners and seams. The walls are plastered to a very flat, smooth finish and texture added to the fiber panel walls to match the ceiling drywall texture. In the sample house, one wall has been left partially finished to clearly show the two steps used to finish the interior walls. First, the tape and the base coat are applied. Second, the finished texture coat is applied. The finished paint coat is applied last. This finished wall makes it easy to see how simple a fiber panel wall can be erected and finished, serviceable for many years to come. The panels, foam, stucco, and ceramic paint used to construct and insulate the sample house in Phoenix, Arizona, gave the exterior walls an approximate R value of 16 to 22. The choice of insulation and finish materials for the exterior walls will alter the insulation values. The fiber panel can also be sealed and simply covered with the CIP insulation coating. The interior walls of the house are comparable to the conventional textured drywall houses, yet are much stronger and virtually fire and termite proof. The fiber panel sample house is indeed a marvel. 1,620 square feet under roof and 1,256 square feet livable space, all for less than $30,000. Fiber panel is the advanced construction technology of the future, today.